Second game of a doubleheader here this afternoon. And Florida State taking on Charleston Southern here at the Seminole Softball Complex. A familiar look to this Buccaneers lineup. We just saw them earlier this afternoon in a game that started a little after 3. And just like in game 1, Sandvik wastes no time swinging on the first offering up the middle, and Hartley puts her away. Boy, that could work. Beecham couldn't pick it. Weakly out in front, Wesleyn Jones does just enough, and the freshman, Irwin, will be at third. Ground ball back to Danley. She gets the force at second. That'll be the second out here of this opening inning of work for Danley. Player of the year, the number 2 freshman in the class. Two-way player, batted nearly 700. Whoa, what a play! Edenfield rifled that throw right in there, and Hartley applied the tag.
The opposite side of the bag and still getting the runner out. What a fantastic Nothing too powerful, but definitely something different than what Florida State saw in the previous game.
Kerr pulls that one down the line, and applying the tag at first base is Schoenweiss, who two arms. We've doubled our staff now to 4. And she said, we'll expect to see each one of the 4 here against Florida State today. Line drive, snagged it short. All right then.
That you get those outs really quickly and that your defense is working behind you.
I'll tell you what's working. That swing is working for Harding. Into the gap it goes, and that'll be a 2-out double for Ocho.
Absolutely throws a missile to third base, Sydney Sherrill, to get the runner tagged out at third.
Yeah, I believe that was Mendez, Nicole Mendez for Oklahoma, as that line drive is snared in left field. Florida State, question though, is for me at least, if and when she goes to the outfield, as that ball does into shallow right field, does she have the same dance moves that Kat Sandercock put on display? Some small ball here. That'll move the runner. Prince does her job.
Been down for the count, but she's all right.
I mentioned in game 1 for Madeline Lee that she had a .241 batting average. That is a bullet throw by Edenfield, but just a tad late. On the ground, this is to short. Play is to first. And Youngman will score.
Grounder hit to Issa Torres in a weird spot. It gives the runner at third just enough time to slide in.
In the Seminoles, Charleston Southern jumps on the board first. Likely Kingsmore, the pinch runner, coming in to score off the ground ball to short. Oh, and one to Emma Villascusa. Ground ball here to Beecham at third. Play is in time to first to retire Villascusa.
I love how she looks so in control, though. It doesn't look like she ever is getting too emotional in the game. She always keeps that just really, not stern, but.
Ross on the run. That gets into center field. There is the chaos she can create. And she turns for third, and just like that, Florida State has the potential tying run day in this game, in particular the DP, and she'll walk.
Laufer really respecting Amaya Ross.
The on-deck circle, there she is, waiting in the wings. Got underneath that one as well. Yorman calling off her pitcher and says, I'll take care of this one, thank you very much.
Incredibly talented hitter. Not somebody that you want to mess around with at the plate.
And I'll tell you what, she's got some wheels too. That ball fell dead right in front of the plate. The only play was to first, and Danley was safe. We're knotted up at 1. Ross scores easily.
Stanley hits this off the very end of the bat, so it turns into more of a swinging bunt, but that's okay when you've got a Meyer Ross at third base who can turn on the speed and
Knowles quickly respond with a one-run bottom of the second and perhaps still counting as Matty Fry is in scoring position. This one lifted into the shortstop territory. Villascusa corrals the pop-up.
Veteran Jani Kerr steps up to the plate, and a hard ground ball stopped at first base will be out number three for the Seminoles.
Oh, what a pitch by Danley.
They have power, 1-9. Fantastic strikeout pitch by Ashton Day. Fry there to back her up. It's a really long season, so being able to put in Fry to get Edenfield some rest, it's really awesome.
On the ground, a second. Hartley puts away Westland Jones at first. Nice inning of work for Danley.
We're same travel ball team together, so they've been playing for a while.
And that is a tremendous swing for Torres over the glove of Westland Jones and left. Extra bases for the freshman who jumped. Point that you were making about the freshmen and how they've acclimated. Kaylee Harding lifted this one to foul territory. Schoenwise corrals it and fires a dart to third to hold the freshman Torres. Softball nerds, they've been sponges. They've been soaking up all the information, and that exuberance, that hunger to learn and to grow has really been a catalyst for this team. And she said on the flip side,
throughout this season so far, and that's not something that you normally see. Normally you see heavy reliance on the upperclassmen, the freshmen. You know, there may be one or two.
Wow, another line drive shot. Ross, have yourself a weekend. She's still after it. A double to straightaway center field, and Florida State leads by one.
Amaya. Amazing hit by Ross. This pitch just right down the middle, and she sends it to center field, scoring Issa Torres. Ross turns on the wheels as she rounds first base to turn this into a double.
Bat box here in the third for Florida State. Ross with the two-out double to score Torres, and now she herself in scoring position for Michaela Edenfield. Edenfield, see you later.
Michaela Edenfield, area 51. She does it again. Another home run on the weekend. This pitch down the middle again, and Michaela, nice swing, lifts that ball into left center field. Two more runs added to the board for the Florida State Seminoles.
And in the blink here, and we'll walk. Another quality plate appearance by this Florida State lineup.
She's got the power for sure.
Looking for her second hit on the season. This one out in front. And I'll tell you what, she'll beat the throw. How about the Knowles running the bases? They've got them on the corners. I'll correct myself. Danley had an infield single earlier in this game, so now two infield singles for Ashton.
Right back up the middle for Harp.
And that'll put an end to a great third inning for Florida State, whose lead is now
inning. So it's extremely effective for Danley, the freshman.
That's Kaylin Arnold, the 2017 SEC Freshman of the Year, also an all-ACC pitcher right here at Florida State. National runner-up a few
years. Just crazy numbers.
I want to ask you a little bit about that when it comes to Ashton Danley, because she ended up, hang on for a second, that's a hot shot to first. Ross got the glove on it and steps on the bag.
Into the fire, and honestly, as a freshman, or at least me, like going into that moment, like no matter who it is that you're playing, and Danley, I mean, just absolutely kills it. She doesn't care who she's throwing to, gets that.
I believe.
She does, definitely. You can tell she's got a lot more velo on this ball than her counterparts on the pitching staff. And I've never heard of the Heisman, so that's in, maybe that's just a South Carolina thing.
Not sure, as that just misses its spot. Torres works the full count walk. And does, but she has found ways to contribute in several different defensive positions, and she creates really strong ABs. There's another one right there for Ocho, a sharp single into right. Had a hit in the first game here today against Charleston Southern. Now looking for her first in this one. And this could be trouble. There it is. And it'll score a run. Beecham drives in another. And Florida State increases their lead. Freshman plating freshman. Beecham taking care of Torres.
I know that's a pitcher when you know that the person you're throwing to has a lot of power. So your outfield is playing back. And because of that, left fielder wasn't able to come in and make that play on that pop-up. Many games. I mean, usually, you know, you're gonna fail a little bit more often, but not a Maya Ross.
That'll drop. And Florida State's got them loaded. Ducks are on the pond for the Seminoles, and Ross is now 8 of 9.
Crazy numbers. This is definitely who Florida State wants to.
And down she goes, Lamb, wow!
Wow, indeed.
Boy, this could be trouble again. Into the Bermuda Triangle, and a couple of runs will score. Play came all the way into the plate, and so Waycaser advanced another 60 feet into scoring position herself.
This pitch up in the zone, Waycaser gets underneath it for the pop-up right over second base, but too far for center fielder to make a play on it. Like I was a little frustrated that we weren't able to make that out.
Yeah, Jocelyn Allo, the all-time home run queen. It makes sense that you'd have outfielders at the wall. Dak underneath this one, and that'll put an end to another strong inning for Florida.
This year, you know, she's had an entire other year to be able to develop, and she's done really well so far.
And she battles back for the strikeout right there.
Spin it differently. We worked on my mechanics. We had to change a few things. I didn't use my legs as much as I could have, and I ended up throwing a little bit harder, put on a lot more muscle in the weight room, I think.
1-0 to Emma. And right back to Allison Royalty in the circle, who says, no problem, I'll put you away. A nice, efficient in. Southern's had some opportunities, but they were 0 for 3 with runners on base. Here's Hartley stepping back into the lineup straightaway center and secured.
Many different things that they're able to do. Speed game, power, small ball.
Nothing small about that. It's going to be secured by Johnson nonetheless. And Manwin Kerr at this point this season. You got Edenfield just shy of 400. And that laser to short will drop out of the glove of Villascusa.
That ball, so much power and so much spin. Haley Harding up at the plate. You want them to swing.
This flare into the glove at second.
With everyone that she possibly could, making the 5-hour drive to get a lesson in every single week. She knew this is where she wanted to be. She did everything that she possibly could to get here, and now she's living the dream. Do you end up with something like that?
It's been a lot of fun to watch this program grow. Annie Potter, the new shortstop, couldn't quite catch up to that infield ground ball by Karsten Sandvik. We'll wait as Wesleyn Jones steps in. Top of the order here, Sandvik 1, Jones 2. Ground ball here to Ross. She'll step on the bag unassisted. Two down. Got the start in the backstop. 1-2. And there's a strikeout once again for Allison Royalty to put an end to the Buccaneers' 6. It's always possible that the Bucks could have a big run in the top of the seventh. But Jason Beecham and the Noles want a call game here. She put a charge into that one. What a start to the bottom of the sixth for Florida State. She's getting on base over 65% of the time and growing. Her on-base percentage. One and one. And this will drop in shallow center. You got to respect the power of Edenfield. Charleston Southern did just that. Waycaser jumps on the first one. Ranging out. Lee, what a play! Florida State will tack on another, though. Beecham will score. Edenfield tries to scamper in the scoring position and, in fact, will.
Nice heads-up base running by the Florida State Seminoles. Jasoni Beecham seeing the direction that this ball is taking. Able to come in easy. Score another run.
Avenue to race in and score a game-ending run. Not to be. 3-2 to Dak. And she'll walk. And Caitlin, we've talked about Charleston Southern's approach and team-based approach. I want to talk about Florida State as well.
Has something that they are bringing to the table.
Hartley to short, play at the plate, gets away, Ross scores, that's it.
This hit by Christina Hartley gets on top of it, but the throw a little too far inside the base path, and Amaya Ross able to score yet again for the Florida State Seminoles. We have seen Amaya Ross just have, I don't even have words for the weekend that she's had. She has been on fire. We saw a fantastic pitching.